Hello everybody, you join me today in the Rage Manufactorium for an episode about industrial craft machines. We're going to go from here, covering a couple of the basic machines and a few of the advanced ones, over to the other mini factory I have over that way to look at some of the more advanced machines. Then we're going to head out into the field way over there to look at a very special machine called the Terraformer. So, without further ado, let's get started. As you can see here, first we have the one machine in industrial craft that does not require any power to function, and that is the iron furnace. The iron furnace is just like a regular furnace. It accepts fuel in the bottom slot and smelts or cooks items in the top slot, except that it has, I think it was 125% fuel efficiency. So for every four fuel, you'll get one bonus fuel, basically. And it cooks at 125% speed, so it'll cook one item faster for every four items. So it's better than a regular furnace if you have the eight iron needed to craft it. Now we get on to machines that actually use energy. So to begin, we have the compressor. The compressor is going to compress items into more compact forms. For example, it can make dense copper plates out of copper ingots. Compressed plants out of a plant ball, a snowball out of a water cell, mixed metal ingots compressed to make advanced alloys, which are very useful, coal balls compressed to compressed coal balls, etc., etc. So to use a compressor, all you have to do is put an item that is compressible, not coal dust, into the compressor. I don't actually have anything on me. I suppose we can use some copper really fast. I thought coal dust is compressible. So let me grab some copper out of here. Let's compress that up real fast. As you can see, the progress bar will move slowly towards the other end, and eventually it'll pop out a little copper plate. As you can notice, this is a pretty slow process. So what people like to do is take something called a overclocker upgrade. These are pretty pretty difficult to make. Let me just look up the recipe here really fast. Yeah, they can get pretty pricey with these 10k coolant cells. There's the pain to make. Not too pricey actually, just kind of a pain. Anyway, here's the dense copper plate that we were promised. So let's take a look at that again using the overclocker upgrades. As you can see, speed is greatly improved with each overclocker upgrade I put in. And there you have it. That's the compressor. The extractor does a different function. It's going to extract things from other things. So we extract a H coal cell into a coal fuel cell, or a water cell into a hydration cell, or diamond ore into two diamonds, or coal ore into three coal. Or the main use in early game is extracting rubber tree saplings, rubber wood, and sticky resin into rubber, which is essential for your early game industrial craft shenanigans. So we're going to stick some sticky resin in there. We're going to grab the overclockers, throw them in there. And each sticky resin is going to make three rubber, but that's the point of the extractor. So we're going to leave that for now. This is the canning machine. The canning machine is going to take food and put it into cans for you. As you can see, the progress bar fills up. You'll notice that there's no slots for upgrades, so we can't apply the overclocker upgrades here. An interesting little thing there. It's going to do four at a time, however, so you'll get four filled tin cans of food that you can nom on whenever you'd like. Let me take my lifestone off my hot bar, so maybe later we can nom on some food. The vacuum canner is going to do the exact same thing, except a lot faster. There you go. I believe. Oh, yep, there it goes. Now, the thing with these advanced machines, you'll see that this has a little vacuum at 2% thing. As that value increases, as the machine spins up, so to speak, the speed at which the machine does its process is going to increase very, very swiftly. As you can see, it's already spinning up and getting faster and faster and faster, and the process is going faster. Not only that, but it's going to draw a hell of a lot of energy. Like, these machines will kill your power system very quickly, but they'll complete operations at lightning speed without the need of overclockers. So kind of a trade-off. You have to decide what's better for you, speed or energy consumption.
Actually, that's not true. Advanced machines are a lot more expensive to craft. However, once they start spinning up, the advanced machines are a lot more energy efficient than standard machines. To begin with, they draw more power than standard machines, but once they're at 100% spin or heat or whatever, they're going to use a lot less energy than standard machines by far, and complete the process much faster. So, yeah, don't listen to past me, listen to me now.
That's the vacuum canner. Next is the electrolyzer, and this is a little bit weird, because what you do with the electrolyzer is you put water cells into the electrolyzer, and when this MFSU, which is a power storage unit, which we'll cover in a totally different episode, when this MFSU is at 70% capacity, which means when it's at, what, 700 million EU or 70 million, something like that? 70 million EU, it's going to electrolyze this water cell and make it an electrolyzed water cell, basically. And that's used for different things. So not a terribly handy machine. Next, we have a very interesting machine called the teleporter. And the teleporter does exactly as its name suggests. It teleports a player or a mob that's standing on top of the teleporter to another teleporter within a radius. So to use this teleporter, you need to make a frequency transmitter. And let me right-click here an open air to unlink the frequency transmitter. And if we right-click on the teleporter and then turn around and right-click on another teleporter, it says teleportation link unchanged, but that's because I had them linked beforehand. So basically, those are now linked, and what we can do is stand on top of the teleporter and apply a redstone signal and... Oops. My bad. I was holding shift. Oop. Wow, look at that. We've moved all the way over here. Now that can obviously be used on a much larger scale if you make teleporters that are a lot further away. However, be warned, the more items of armor you're wearing, the more items you have in your inventory, and the longer or the farther you travel with the teleporter, it uses more and more EU. So this could put a serious strain on your power system. Next up is the electric furnace. The electric furnace smelts items. So if we take some iron ore, for example, put it in there, going to smelt that up pretty fast with those overclocker upgrades. As you can see, it's just normal smelting of some ore. It can also be used for sticky resin to make rubber. And, you know, anything else that you could use a furnace for, you can use an electric furnace for. However, the macerator is a item that can kind of work in tandem with the electric furnace if used correctly. And we'll go over this in more detail when we cover the ore doubling videos in a future video. But this macerator is going to chew up iron ore, or any ore for that matter, and make dust out of it. As you can see, it can do uranium into uranium ore, and bone into bone meal, coal ore into coal dust, which can also turn coal into coal dust, things like that. All sorts of ores, like I said, nether ores included, for the most part. Gravel into flint. Anyway, this is going to eat all of these, and then what you can do, if you notice, I only put 5 iron ore in there, and I got 10 iron dust out. That's strange. What does this iron dust do? You can indeed smelt this iron dust to create 1 ingot. Therefore, you are essentially doubling your ingot amount by turning the ores into dust first. So an interesting trade-off. Very interesting indeed. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to go over to the carbon neutral factory and I'm going to cut a little bit. So I will see you when we're over there. Here we are at the good old definitely not carbon neutral factory. And if we walk inside here, we're going to see, ignoring this mess over here for the time being, we're going to see a bunch of very advanced machines. You can kind of tell if a machine is advanced if it has this little double square pattern on top of it, but not all of them have that, of course. So like I said earlier, these machines rely on a speed or heat or pressure mechanic, something that keeps them spinned up and ready to make more product very fast at a large energy cost. The centrifugal extractor does the same thing as a regular extractor, albeit much faster, making rubber out of sticky resin. The macerator does the same thing as the regular macerator, the rotary macerator, however. It'll make this iron dust. The induction furnace is going to do the same thing that the regular furnace does. However, the induction furnace can make alloys. If we open up the, there's no recipe tab, but I believe that you can make bronze in the furnace, in the induction smelter. I thought you could. I guess not. The induction smelter is going to smelt, it can smelt two stacks of items at a time. Boom, boom, boom. So much faster. And then the singularity compressor is going to do the same thing that the regular compressor did, is compress into different things. Now you'll notice that these levers are on the side of these advanced machines, and that is because if you apply a redstone signal to these machines, this heat value or this pressure value will never decrease, but it will keep drawing energy passively. So if we flick that off, in a moment you should see that the heat level will begin to drop. Alright folks, we are over behind the Rage Manufactorium here, you can see it off in the distance. Now we're going to take a look at the Terraformer, which is going to be the last machine that I'm going to showcase here in this video. The Terraformer runs by these cartridges called TFBPs. There's a number of different TFBPs, and each of them have different effects. The mushroom one will create mushrooms around an area, the flatification one will flatify an area, the desertification one will cause sand to appear, chilling will cause snow and ice, irrigation will cause water and farmland, I believe, cultivation will cause plants, flowers, trees, pumpkins to grow, and empty is just the base component that you fill with ingredients to make any of these. So all you have to do is to right-click on a terraformer with a TFBP, and today we're using desertification just to show... Oh, wow. This is being powered by 3 high-voltage solar arrays, but this result is very, very swift. It's a lot faster than I thought it would be. I think it's just because it's sucking up so much power, using so much power. So as you can see, it's turning a pretty large radius of blocks around it into desert. And that is actually going impressively fast and stretching it rather far as well. I'm kind of worried that this thing is going to get a little too close to comfort for the Rage Manufactorium. It's going very far. The radius, as you can see, is rather wide. I don't know if this is going to cause cacti to spawn, but definitely it is turning the grass blocks into sand. Oh, and there, a tree just grew there. I had the cultivation one inserted into the terraformer beforehand just so I could get a really noticeable difference. But yeah, the result of this terraforming is rather swift. Actually, I'm going to just spawn in a mushroom terraforming thing just to see a different result. I think the mushroom one is in place. Yes, there's mycelium growing right now. Very, very fast. Look at that. Very fast mycelium growth. Maybe not quite as fast as the desert, but it's picking up. So there you have it. As you can see, there are very powerful and useful machines in industrial craft, and some of them are just plain fun, like this terraformer here. That's all for today, I think. If you enjoyed the video, I hope you will subscribe and like. And I hope this was informative and maybe a little bit entertaining. I hope that you guys enjoyed, and until next time, take care.